The pandemic has profoundly disrupted several industries across the world, where the supply chain has halted, work has stopped, and other related issues have emerged. However, each challenge comes with a silver lining, and this pandemic proved to be one for companies who are working with emerging technologies like artificial intelligence, machine learning, and analytics. In fact, in recent news, Microsoft has assured their investors that COVID-19 had a minimal net impact on their company's revenue. Instead, the company has been witnessing a rise in its cloud business amid this pandemic. Similarly, HCL has also stated to the media that the pandemic is not going to have any significant impact on their business. This pandemic has indeed forced companies to rethink their business and technology strategies. However, companies that have already adopted AI and machine learning have an upper hand of being a front runner during these uncertain times. To dig deeper, Analytics India magazine spoke to Ashwin Chalam, the CEO of Bridged AI, to understand how businesses are looking to transform their manual work processes to a more digitized system in order to have a business continuity amid this crisis. This, in turn, provides several opportunities for companies who have already leveraged new age technologies in their day-to-day operations. The company Bridged AI, that provides AI training datasets powered by human intel, believes that this pandemic has brought in a silver lining for companies like them.
Oh, absolutely. For us, there is a silver lining because there is going to be a concerted effort by most companies globally to sort of move away from manual processes that they had in place previously and start adopting newer technologies like, you know, artificial intelligence. So, you know, as we're seeing a dip, you know, in our sales pipeline as of now, we are of the opinion that in the future, right, we're going to see a large concerted global effort for companies to start moving away from, you know, manual processes that they did previously and start adopting artificial intelligence at scale.
Ashwin also believes that the healthcare industry heavily leveraging AI to fight this pandemic would provide immense opportunities for the company to expand its business.
We're seeing artificial intelligence being adopted at scale to shorten the time frame, right, which it would typically take to create a vaccine. And I think, you know, if you look at the healthcare space and, you know, biosciences and any of these sectors, I think you're going to see mass adoption of AI to be able to sort of come to a cure or create a prevention measure like a vaccine at much, much faster rates.
Agreeing to that, Alok Paskar, President and CEO of JK Technosoft, has also stated that artificial intelligence and analytics would gain traction and that would bring opportunities for companies.
AI and analytics. People used to think about AI separate from analytics. No, AI and analytics will have to come together, which is associated also then with RPA types of technologies that are out there. It will become very predominant is workforce management oriented technology.
The company has also been witnessing a massive traction in its AI business amid this crisis.
Now we are seeing a lot of requirements from our existing customers on the RPA automation side, and which they further want to then take to the analytics side. So we are seeing that trend already happening.
On the other hand, Suman Reddy, the Managing Director of Pegasystems India, believes that cost reduction could be another reason for businesses to currently digitize their processes, and that in turn pushes the adoption of AI and robotics technologies among enterprises.
I think for some industries where now where they see a longer recovery path, you know, because of the short term, with the whole, you know, the losses that they incur, you might see them investing a lot more on digital process automation, which allows them to optimize their business and save some costs. Some cost-saving measures will be adopted by industries, and therefore I see that robotic process automation and digital process automation actually might get a kick from a technology perspective.
So as Arvind Krishna once said in his keynote, every company will become an AI company. Therefore, the faster businesses transform their legacy to new age technologies, the better they will be positioned to survive the post-pandemic world.